Pamela Barotti. I've been in marketing, customer advocacy, communications for nearly 2 decades. I've worked for startups, medium-sized and global companies like MasterCard, Amazon, Oracle, and now I'm with Microsoft, where I'm head of customer advocacy. But I'm also a qualified personal performance coach, executive coach, and for the last nearly decade, I've had the pleasure to coach and mentor people in the UK and abroad. I've also launched learning programs with the Institute of Marketing. I've been on the board for 4 years, and also some other organizations. But I'm super excited because what I share with you today is based on my experience, but also on the experience and research of so many amazing professionals, from neuroscience to social psychologists. What I share here with you, you can go share with your teams and implement right away. So there we go. I've already did the intros. And why I love talking about soft skills? Well, from experience, you can have the best strategy. You can buy, you know, the best technology, hopefully from Microsoft. But if you and your team don't have the right soft skills, it'll be very difficult for you to be successful and your organization to be successful. But let's look at it. So here we have the top 10 skills of 2025. That is based on that research by the World Economic Forum. So, and I'm very happy to share these slides afterwards. So, you know, if you look at the 10 different skills, they classify them maybe in 4 types of skills. So we have problem solving, self-management, work with people, technology use and development. And what I think is fascinating is that 3 out of the 4 are related to soft skills. But let's go a step further. Let's look at it, marketers, right? So of course, we are here in the CMO Inspired Summit, so let's be very specific. So this is from the Chart Institute of Marketing, one of the leading marketing professional bodies. And again, work with companies and do a lot of research. They create this framework, if you may. So for marketing professionals to be successful, you need to have master three types of skills. Core, so we have the insights, customer focus, strategy. Then you have the the technical, so partnership marketing, brand, digital marketing. And outside here in the gray, you have behavior. And that's what, you know, we have the soft skills. So you need to, you know, to be able to influence stakeholders, collaborate, be creative. But in my experience, But in my experience, there is one soft skills that is based for all of them. And this is confidence. And that's what I want to focus on today. There are so many different definitions of what confidence is. And I want to ask the audience, what is confidence? Who is confident to tell me what confidence is? Let's see.
Courage of your conviction.
Yeah, I love that. Believe in yourself. Great. Excellent. Absolutely. So there are a lot of definitions out there. But for today's sessions, I want you to think about it. Confidence as a feeling of trust in your abilities, qualities, and judgments. So I'm going to ask you, raise your hand if you think you're confident. Great. I love when I ask this, I love it because I see the confidence. Yeah. And then the ones like, maybe. So actually, I would like to respectfully challenge that. I don't think anyone is confident full stop or is not confident full stop. Your level of confidence depends on the circumstances, right? So let's say if you start a new job, even if you're a seasoned CMO, in the beginning you feel like, ooh, not sure, you're building relationships, learning about the business, right? And then you master, you feel confident. Even your personal life, right? So like, I'm from Brazil, I've been here for, 14 years, you have the accent, so you have to keep up with that. Sorry, guys. And I'm very, even the personal life, right? I'm a great dancer, but I'm a very bad cook, OK? okay? If I ever invite you for dinner, well, you know, maybe you should have dinner beforehand. But anyway, just in a very straightforward way, right? So confidence, what I encourage you to think about is not, yeah, I am or I'm not. It depends on the circumstances. Also, the way I like to approach this, it is to, look at that three building blocks, which we're going to discuss in a moment. But I'm curious, why do you need confidence? More like in a marketing and business content. An idea why marketeers need to be confident?
To inspire and persuade.
Yes, inspire and persuade, absolutely.
Definitely to influence, because often marketing is seen as an afterthought strategically.
Absolutely.
So you need to be able to invite yourself at the table to start.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree more. You know, I think the more confident marketeers are, more likely we're going to have a seat on the table and put customers in the center of the organization. Absolutely. Yeah.
We tend to be mavericks, try to take risks, and we've got to experiment a lot, so we need confidence as well.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So we all of this, absolutely, as a business leaders. And your team as well, right? So your team also needed to deliver presentations. You know, if you're on the Asian side, right, we pitch for a new business, request budget. I mean, regardless if you work for a startup or a global company, there was a little bit of a fight, right, over budget. So you need to be confident to request for that. Imagine stakeholders, share insights, and ask for pay rise and promotion. My team says that, you know, or people sometimes who deliver this presentation say, Pamela, after your talk, my entire team came to me asking for promotion and pay rise. Anyway, so there we go. But how can you boost your confidence, right? So I talk about the three building blocks. That's my approach. So first, I like to think about the skills, right? So again, I mean, for those of you who arrive a little bit late, I'm happy to share these slides, but we talk about it. We look at some skills that we needed to be successful, and also skills specifically for marketing. So for you, including the soft skills, but you need to make sure that you continue to develop the skills that are going to make you successful now and in the future. Then, that's the thing that I like most, because there is also ways that you can boost your confidence through your body. And you're going to explore that. And through your mindset. So hopefully, you know, we start evolving from, yeah, I'm confident, not confident, to look at it. Confidence depends on the, you know, setting that you are. And there are three ways that you can boost it. So let's look at the confidence through your body first. So Dr. Amy Cuddle, she delivered a TED Talk called Your Body Language Shapes Who You Are. And she's a well-known social psychologist from Stanford, and she did a lot of research where she saw the impact of body language has in the body. So depending on how you sit, how you stand, your body creates different chemicals and then can make you more stressed or can make you calmer. Can make your brain think in a very clear way or be a little stressed. And that certainly has an impact, you know, on how you feel and how your confidence is and how able you are to present your strategies, to influence the board and do your job. So, I make sure it's a interactive workshop. The guy's gonna do something in a minute. So she come up with almost two types of postures, right? There is what she called power pose and the low power pose. So for the power pose, it's the interesting thing is testosterone goes up and cortisol goes down. So ladies in the room, don't worry, okay? The testosterone is not going to make you masculine or anything. But actually, increasing the level of testosterone in the brain helps the brain to think in a very clear manner. And cortisol, I think most of you know that is a hormone, right, associated with stress. And let's face it, if you feel stressed, if you are not your best version, you can influence, you can barely function. So just by changing your posture, you can start shifting those chemicals. So I want you to invite you all. Let's stand up, please. Let's inhale, big inhale. Exhale. Whoa. So the posture that I'm going to share with you, she called, Superwoman or Superman, okay, or super whatever you wanted. So basically, it's you put your hands here, yeah. So what I also, I want you to imagine that there is an invisible line pushing you up, okay? So don't need to go there, but just kind of put your shoulders back, you know, your like this, yeah. So according to her research, if you stay in this posture for at least 2 minutes, you're gonna start seeing a shift on how you feel. Don't worry, you're not gonna be there for 2 minutes. You can sit down. You'll look fabulous. So what I wanted to encourage is that, and of course, right, you're all seasonal professional. I mean, nowadays we have a lot of meetings, right? Hopefully use Teams, not Zoom, but if you do, I forgive you. I forgive you, but the good thing is, of course, you're not gonna turn up, imagine your next, you know, your next conference call, you're like, hello, you know, that's not what I'm saying. But even if you are like me, I have a lot of, back-to-back calls, I work from home a lot. If I have, particularly if I have important meeting with a customer, a stakeholder, I'm mindful, I'm sitting down, but my shoulders are back, I imagine the invisible line, my posture changes. But the beauty of posture is that not only we feel different, but research shows that, particularly for presenting, if you're standing this posture here like I am, apparently the audience perceives you as more credible. So again, just be mindful that this has an impact on how you feel internally, but also how people perceive you. Equally, some postures they should call, you know, lower power postures. So again, they increase cortisol and they decrease testosterone. So, you know, and it's natural. When you feel stressed, you're not feeling confident, you're not having a great day, it's normal for us to be a little like that, right? Close and heads down. So just try to the opposite, because otherwise you get into the circle, right? You feel bad and you feel down and then you feel down and just has an impact. So just be mindful of the postures. So before we get into supplements, I also want to talk about briefly about pranayama. Does anyone know what it is? So great, so you learned something. So pranayama means breathing control in Sanskrit, which is, you know, it's an Indian language. So it's beautiful. We can control the way we feel just by changing the way we breathe. And that's so many research done and shows. So everything I share here, you know, is backed up by research. And I do some of these techniques help you to get a lot of energy. I certainly don't need that. I do the other ones more to relax or calm down or help me to center. And in my career, I had the opportunity to see global leaders using those techniques between meetings or, you know, to self-regulate themselves, particularly if they have to deliver bad news or if there's a bit of a conflict. So I want us to do a quick one. I'm just going to show. And don't worry, you're gonna be sitting. So it's very straightforward. We're gonna inhale in five, like, and exhale in five. Did you get it? Yeah? So let's do it together. First, let's take a deep inhale. Exhale. You can close your eyes if you like or keep it open. So I'm counting, then you inhale. So inhaling, one, two, three, four, five, and you exhale, one, two, three, four, five. One more time, inhale, one, two, three, four, five, exhale, one, two, three, four, five. And for the last time, inhale, one, two, three, four, five, exhale, one, two, three, four, five. Big inhale and exhale. How does it feel? It's different, right? I mean, of course, we just did a few times, so I encourage you to do for at least 3 minutes. But, you know, just smile for the one you'll be here. with me for 3 minutes doing that. There's a lot of content I want to share. But I just encourage, just for you to see, it's very straightforward. You can do anywhere, in a meeting or even a personal life. If you have a hot date, you're nervous, do a bit of breathing, with kids as well. So anyone can do it, and really, it shifts your state of mind, particularly if you suffer from anxiety or if you get very agitated or if you have a lot of meetings. It just helps you, almost like hit refresh, and then you go again. Supplements. I mean, of course, I'm not a medical doctor, so but what I encourage you to look at it. If you're feeling extremely tired, if your level of confidence extremely low, if you're suffering from high anxiety, you might want to speak to your GP and to your doctor and ask for some tests. Because there's a lot of research, one specifically by Dr. Mark Neer. He's a well-known bestseller. And he did a lot of work around this, you know, the lack of certain vitamins and supplements in the body can really make you down. And of course, this is not new to you, but what I encourage you is speak to your doctor. Even if you see someone on your team struggling, you know, lack of omega-3 or lack of iron, all of this has a huge impact. For me personally, I've always been very energetic and I was feeling really down for no reason. Turns out I was lacking iron. So it's very, very powerful to see the link between our confidence, our performance, how our body is feeling. The next one is about clothes. Actually, I love this one. So no, I'm not encouraging you to go and spend a lot of money on clothes, not at all. But what I think is fascinating is that there is an area of psychology that's called enclothed cognition. So they studied the impact that clothes have on your cognitive behavior. One of the research, it's quite interesting. So they got two groups of people, and they sent them to a lab to perform some tasks. One group, and the same background, you know, same age, like one group were given like a beautiful white doctor coat. The other one wasn't. And the research shows that actually those who were given the white coat were actually performing better than those who didn't. So it's very important for us to also be mindful of the impact that clothes have on our cognitive behaviors. And again, if you're feeling down, you might want to have your special clothes. Also collars. Pantone organization in the US, they are experts on color, and they work with a lot of brands to make recommendations on what colors they should use it to communicate better with the customers. But also shows the colors have an impact on, again, how people perceive you and how you feel. So again, just another tool for you to consider. Next one is how to boost your, how to boost your confidence through your mindset. So I love this. It's called reticular activating system. So this is part of the brain, and this is almost like I'm going to explain a very simple terms. Again, I'm not a doctor, but just so we understand, it's part of the brain that almost filters and makes decisions on what we're going to focus on, right? So at any given moment, we are bombarded with information, with stimulus. And this helps the brain to filter, like, what do I focus on? So an example, so when I was in university in Brazil, my father gave me a car. So I'm from São Paulo, you have to drive it anywhere. And I got a black Ford Fiesta, and I was so excited. As soon as I left the dealer, I started seeing black Ford Fiesta everywhere. And guess what? It wasn't like a promotion or an advertising. Why? Because it was my awareness, right? Another example, I don't have kids, but if you have it, or if your wife, if a father or mother, my friends say, wow, I start seeing pregnant women everywhere, right? Or babies, or even at work, right? If you're working on launching a product, you start seeing that product everywhere because we are focused on that. So what I encourage you is, particularly if we work with people, is that I think we tend to be very hard on ourselves. Okay, usually we don't have time for this, a workshop, but we can do at home. One exercise that I love it is this one. So I encourage people to think about it, what qualities they have, what skills, what achievements, and have a list. You know, I have that on my phone, on the computer. And what is interesting is that, you know, if I'm running, let's say, a half-day workshop or have more time, I say, okay, write down your qualities. And people are like, oh, I'm not sure. Oh, I don't know. If I ask the opposite, right, write things that you don't like, they're like, oh, Pamela, I need more paper. There's so much stuff. So what I'm encouraging here is not for you to ignore, okay? It's not to pretend, oh, everything's fine. Not at all. But it's a shift in perception, okay? Let's start with, okay, what are your skills? What are your qualities? What are your achievements? And can be professional and can be personal as well. You know, and then when you start from that mindset, you feel, remember the, you know, the reticular activation system, your brain is going to start seeing more evidence for that. And with that knowledge, the energy, you are more equipped, you know, you have more chance to tackle those areas that you want to develop. Oh, next one is, this slide is from Dr. Joe Dispenza. So he's a well-known neuroscientist. And he did a lot of work about it. How would emotions impact our body? So every emotions that we have create different chemicals in the body. And then, of course, impacts on how you feel, how you perform, how we see things. So he classified the emotions in almost like two types. Elevate emotions and limited emotions. So the elevated emotions are the ones that say we like to feel more, right? Which is gratitude, love, fun, inspiration. And survival emotions or limited emotions are the one about doubt, fear, worry. So I'm not saying that you should suppress your emotions, right? You have to feel what you feel. And again, if you're struggling, please speak to your doctor. I'm sure they can help. I encourage you to think about more strategically, okay? Because we know you plan your day, you plan your meetings, you plan everything, but why don't plan activities in your diary that are gonna help you to create the emotions that you like it, right? Whether it's joy, whether it's love, whether it's gratitude. Also, next time we have, you know, let's say, you know, you have a big problem in the company, you want to brainstorm, great, but take a step back, do something fun, take your mind off the problem, create the right chemicals that's going to help your brain to perform better, are going to help you to type into inspirations, into creativity, and that's how you can come up with the best solution for the business and be able to drive your marketing strategy, your CX strategy, you know, your engagement with customers, but you and your team need to be in a good place. So, and now we need to create a plan, right? Because I think marketeers here, regardless of your level, I'm sure, you know, you're familiar with strategies and plans and everything. We usually have this for the business, but we forget to have this for yourselves. And that's what I encourage you to do. Again, we're not gonna have time to go details, but I've shared, you know, a bit of framework and you can take these slides later as well. But create a plan for yourself, right? So how do you set your confidence goal or your soft skills or whatever? So I always encourage the audience to choose one skill they wanna improve or could be one area of their life. And then, guess what? Have a SMART goal. I'm sure you're familiar with SMART goal for business, but raise your hand if you have a SMART goal for your personal life. One person, two, three. Okay, few, yeah. Right, so, and again, right, it could be the way you like it, but what it looks like, right? So for example here, let's say you're presenting. So that's what an example, right? I'm confident to present the next global town hall on the date. So whatever it is that you wanted, you are always having the present sentence, okay? Don't focus on no. Don't say, oh, I don't wanna fail. I wanna succeed. You know, the brain doesn't capture the word no. Let's do a trial. Guys, don't think of an apple. You probably thought of an apple. If you didn't, you were think about something else, so get back to the room, right? So again, language is powerful. So again, I'm confident to present. I'm confident, or whatever your goal might be. Confident to launch the new marketing strategy. And write down the steps, right? What you're going to do. Are you going to, if you perhaps want to practice your public speaking, you might want to join Toastmasters, you want to practice, whatever it is. Clear on your goal, write your steps, and date each step. Because I think we all know, life gets busy. If you're in marketing, you probably do 10,000 things at once. But it's good to have that goals for yourself as well, and for your team. You know, so reviews up. Why do we encourage them? Yes, you have your goals for the business. You might have your development plan, but how about yourself? And of course, you know, that they don't need to share personal things with you. There's HR regulations, all of this. But just encourage people, because ultimately, we are 360 individuals, right? If you're feeling good, you will perform better. So for you to drive performance, for you to get the best out of your team and drive loyalty, it is important to give them the opportunity to thrive outside work too. So now it's just, summarize what we look at today. So we talk about confidence, right? I mean, sorry. First we talk about all the skills. Then soft skills, and then I focus on confidence because my experiences, in my view, it is the basic, right, for many soft skills. And you look at it, how do you boost your confidence through the body, through the mind, and also we look at it at how you can implement a plan that can help you and you and your organization, your team to thrive. So my final remarks, I like to use a quote by Marianne Williamson. The thing is, I'm not very good at memorizing, so I kind of adapt the quote. It's half Marianne, half Pamela. But it says that our biggest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our biggest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. We doubt ourselves. We put ourselves down. You say, oh, who am I to get the big job? Or transform the business, or perform better. I ask you, who are you to not be? You have the skills, you have the capability, if you have the right mindset, the growth mindset, I genuinely believe you can nearly do nearly everything that be and do and have that you wanted. So I encourage you, reflect it. I appreciate I shared a lot of content, but what is that one thing that you're gonna take away and you're gonna implement it right away? Is the posture, is the breathing, is you feeling low, you're going to have an appointment with your GP. That's what I encourage you, take away. And thank you so much for listening. I hope you enjoy the session. I would love to connect with you on LinkedIn or via email. Thank you so much.